Measurement confidence. If you look around your office, a room in the house, your company, you might see things like doors, windows, furniture, tables. You may be watching this on your cell phone, tablet, or computer, all of which are manufactured using measurements. Many of us take measurements for granted in our daily activities, such as powering on appliances such as our phones, coffee makers, and trusting weather forecasts without giving a thought. Other activities ensure our safety and comfort, such as doors and windows opening and closing while ensuring a good seal, our houses withstanding a strong wind gust, or the floor not collapsing under our load. Do you know what provides that assurance of safety and comfort? All of these items have been assured using a measuring tool that was calibrated by following a specification, a published standard, or a method. So what if any of these things fail? Does anyone typically question the measurement? Should they? If the person or place responsible for calibrating the equipment has stated that something was good and it fails, they likely may not have in place a system robust enough to establish measurement confidence. Let's look at the system that ensures measurement confidence. Establishing measurement confidence required measurement uncertainty, metrological traceability, and measurement decision risk. Measurement uncertainty, which includes precision, is explained in the International Vocabulary of Metrology. A way to interpret measurement uncertainty is a doubt about the measurement result. Since we do not make perfect measurements, we must consider the error sources. When all the errors are captured properly, we can describe how well we made the measurement, or what our measurement uncertainty is. Some components of measurement uncertainty can be evaluated by type A evaluation or type B evaluation. Metrological traceability. Let's first define metrological traceability. That measurement traces back to the International System of Units, SI. For force and torque, these SI units are time, length, and mass. The pyramid starts with SI at the top, then NMI, National Metrological Institute, like NIST. If NIST did the calibration of the force weights, then the next tier would be a primary reference laboratory like Morehouse. Morehouse performs calibrations on load cells for the lower tiers, accredited calibration suppliers followed by working standards who in turn calibrate field equipment. Measurement uncertainty also keeps us honest. If we think about making a conformity assessment of pass or fail, the larger your measurement uncertainty, the more likely you are to fail an instrument. Using the analogy of a parking space, when your uncertainty is small, you have a parking space large enough to easily park. This small uncertainty means we have more space or range to pass an instrument. However, when your uncertainty is larger, you have less room. If the uncertainty is much larger, you have less range and sometimes no range at all to pass an instrument. Measurement decision risk focuses on understanding decision risk and TUR. When discussing decision rules, we describe how measurement uncertainty is accounted for when stating conformity with a specified requirement. The conformity for most is binary, meaning either a pass or a fail, and some standards recommend setting the limits, so a fail occurs if the total risk is larger than 2%. The laboratory shall document the decision rule employed, taking into account the level of risk. Many of the decision rules found in documents such as the ANSI/Z540.3 handbook and the ILAC G8 use test uncertainty ratio, or TUR, to help calculate their measurement risk. TUR is defined in the handbook as the ratio of the span of the tolerance of a measurement quantity subject to calibration to twice the 95% expanded uncertainty of the measurement process used for calibration. The formula for TUR consists of the span of the tolerance in the numerator. The denominator includes short-term contributions incurred during the calibration, such as repeatability, resolution, error in the measurement source, operator error, error in correction factors, environmental influences, and others. We must standardize definitions when discussing TUR because when significant contributors to measurement uncertainty get omitted, every subsequent measurement will be suspect and bad things may happen. When we use the appropriate formula and draw the concept, we draw the lower and upper specification limits at 999.5 and 1000.5. Next, we put in the location of the measurement at 1000.4. The calculated calibration process uncertainty determines the width of the distribution. As you can see, the larger the measurement uncertainty, the larger the risk relating to the measurement location. The smaller the uncertainty, the lower the risk. Such is the case in this example when Morehouse performs the calibration. The ways to reduce the risk are simple. Follow the formula for TUR. Find calibration labs, such as Morehouse, with the lowest measurement uncertainties. Buy better equipment that is repeatable and has enough resolution. Control the environmental conditions. To ensure confidence in our measurements and make the world a safer place to live in, we need to evaluate measurement uncertainty correctly, ensure metrological traceability, select and apply the decision rule appropriately to make a statement of conformity. Please join us in spreading awareness by sharing this video, as you can help make a positive difference that could prevent a catastrophic event or failure. Be well, stay safe, and make proper measurements. Proudly brought to you by E equals MC3 Solutions and Morehouse Instrument Company.